ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of Made in Japan. Today we're actually taking a look at iCEY. iCEY is here to us from the Hong Kong PlayStation store and is in English. So I'm getting the benefit of English gameplay with a game that I have not seen show up on the European, American, or any of the other stores that I have accounts for. So I'm glad to get to play it. But obviously this has been around for a while. It's been on Steam for a while. So, and I've been, from looking at the Steam forums and the conversation about it, there's been a bit of a weirdness, like the marketing message and what the gameplay is about seems to be slightly kind of nebulous for no apparent reason. I think it may be like a slight ARG thing that was meant to be going on at one point whenever the game came out. But in this particular case, I have know very little other than this is a hack slash, kind of like side-scrolling fighting game. So let's get a wee look inside of it and see if I've got what it takes to take on iCEY. Probably the best way to describe it. I've wanted to actually, what I really, really want to go back to is I'm looking forward to seeing some games. I want to play Mother Russia Bleeds or go back and play Scott Pilgrim vs. the World game because I miss doing those, or Phantom Breakers. Phantom Breakers was actually a pretty good one too, wasn't it? I wouldn't mind playing those scrolling beat-em-ups again. This isn't quite in that place, but at least I can get some kind of sense of that. In fact, if anything, what I could tell from footage and bits and pieces I glanced at before pulling down this game, it seemed to be a bit more like a castle, not Castlevania, but you know, like the old Castlevania, like the original ones, that kind of like platforming, moving through a location, and then occasionally fighting a boss. So here's iCEY. Let's take a look at what we got. iCEY, you see, we all see. Language English, vibration on. No, I do not want to complete game data or restart a set of game data. Again, there's always suffering from the problem of Asia Control Syndrome that circle is confirm, X is cancel. So I almost accidentally confirmed that. I wouldn't have lost anything though, thankfully enough. Oh! Oh! Oh no! Is this. Does this play and look like Dragon's Crown? By its like, combat and a little bit like Earthdawn? Oh! Oh yes, please. Yes. Oh, wow. Okay, so I have to spend money to get... All right. And this is all the moves that I can do? Oh, shit, yeah. When rupturing an enemy's core? Yeah. All right, so I know what I need to do that first. I'm needing to get money, and I'm going to get that so I can survive for longer. But this looks interesting. Oh. Yep, I'm ready. Yeah! Oh! Big finishing blows. Boom! Boom! Is something gratifying about that? Is that actually something I can pick up? No, it's just bits and pieces floating in the air. Right. So I'm starting to get into this. As a scrolling slashing up, it reminds me of a fair amount of games that have actually been out on the PlayStation already. I mean, I actually got... Oh. Oh, yeah. Boom! Down you go. Oh, I wanted this lance. So the cred's floating in the air, telling me how much I got. What's this? Oh, it must be just telling me that I'm inside. So this is some kind of like Jurassic Park-style zoo full of robots. Seems interesting. Absorb energy crystal. All right. Oh, damn! So that's what they do. I did not know that. That's what energy crystals do. Awesome. Soon I'm not meant to fall into the, what looks like a primordial ooze. Everything's like, oh, well, $24. Do I have anything I can buy for $24? No, you do not. All right, fair enough. I'll get to that. But yeah, it's actually essentially gives me more combos to work with. Awesome. Can't see any goodness. Have I got a boss to fight? Somebody gonna appear out of the goddamn moon? Yeah! You Gatling gun wearing motherfucker! Oh shit! Ah, oh, come on! Boom! Oh, it wasn't. So he ran off. I thought I was going to actually be able to get him. No, he came back again. Okay. Oh shit! Move! 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 iCEY! No! Yeah, system crashed. Fix that bin, please do. Right. ITM at your service. Oh shit, what's this? System interface is a self-regulating artificial intelligence system developed by Fantblade. Fantblade reserves the right of final interpretation. Any disputes or damage caused by the system are the responsibility of the system interface itself. Fantblade has no liability of such matters. Read me. Note, a very small percentage of individuals may experience epileptic seizures when exposed to flashing lights in this experiment. The contents of the experiment are not intended to insult or offend. Please do not take anything personally. Note, the contents of this experiment are highly classified. Do not break. Read. Do not break. Share any classified material. Not only per. Only one person is permitted to undertake this experiment at a time. Do not contaminate results. Okay. Right. Have we got a whole Pony Island thing going on here? Interesting. So, is this Pony Island? What the fuck? Is it close open? Okay. Yes. Did I? No. No. In adventure, are battles more important than story? No, man. Oh, right. That's interesting. Right. So did that actually just go through and do a quick dissection of who I am to answer my questions? And then, all right, let's give that another try.
In the middle of the dark, quiet room filled only by the sounds of humming and machines, a figure floats. She, iCEY, has no memories, no past. Memories to her are not important. Her existence only serves one purpose, to kill Judas. That wicked devil, the bringer of the apocalypse. No matter how many difficulties or obstacles she will face, iCEY understands she must accomplish her mission. Destroy Judas. In the darkness, iCEY awakes. Okay. This went... What? Hold... Alright. Hold triangle to start game. She understands that as long as she follows the arrow, she will discover where Judas is hiding. Okay. As more soldiers sent by Judas to kill iCEY. Kill them. Boom. That was interesting. So I'm liking the fact that they're actually putting characters... Whoa. Nice. That's pretty cool. It's kind of like in the mechanics of the combat in this. It feels very, very simple. It feels... there's a bunch of games that I played that actually had this similar kind of like combo system. And recently, Earth Dawn has been the one that I've actually really got into that plays very similarly to this. I mean, it kind of bit of left house as well. So this has actually got a narration, basically because I told it to give it a narration, which is kind of fucked up. I'm really enjoying this. Whoa! Oh, crap! Ah, come on! Ah! Up you go, and down you go. Anything else showing up? Nah. Alright, fair enough. I just slips off the edge of the cliff. Oh, I died! The only way to get across is to use the photon bridge. Okay. So it seems to be like really, really like delineating instructions as if I'm actually a bit of a child whenever it comes to playing this. Couldn't figure it out myself, which is probably fine because I think that's what I actually implied I needed to do. Oh, I'm loving this chain. That was really gratifying. I'm liking the length of that combo. Oh. So if you time it right and you actually end up discussing jobs, I'm moving in front of iCEY, so you must jump across. Yeah. So it's giving me the arrows to tell me where I need to go, which is pretty fine, but it's like having three arrows between each space. It's a little bit overkill. Can I actually build an upgrade? Well, it tells me which ones I can afford. Alright, damage. We launch smaller enemies into the air.
Skullshaker.
Oh, nice. So I've got the knockdown one. Let's skewer. Boom. Slice through. Deadly disc. Have I got someone that's actually a little bit more... Oh, yeah. L1 square. Oh, that's sacrifice health HP. Oh, that's pretty cool. Release shadows which swiftly attack the enemy when their weak point is exposed. Oh, very cool. I think I might take that. When shown over enemy, that's cool. That's the first attack got. And at the very bottom, I really need to actually get enough so I can get... I need 180 to be able to buy
that regeneration because I'm pretty sure it'll keep me alive. I'm fighting smaller enemies. Probably useless against bosses. Yeah, where's the bridge? So essentially, it feels like I'm playing Guardian Heroes now. You know, like that's the Guardian Heroes, but it's like directional kind of like combat. Boom! Down you go. So, like, if nobody has played Garden Heroes, Garden Heroes actually had a very interesting kind of like multi-directional kind of story where if different events that you did at different times and different levels left you to actually have different bosses to fight and had multiple endings to the game and unlocked different heroes as you were playing because you had like 50, 60 different people you could play as. Oh, Jesus. Are you really, really going to tell me to do that? One, two, three, four. Yeah! That's so much more gratifying than the last time I got my ass beat by that fucker. Falls the arrow, passes through the gate. See, I love the fact the narration is just, oh, shit! It's just telling me, yeah, that's exactly what I'm doing. Ah, that feels so good. It's just the fact that the gameplay feels so fluid and combat feels fairly intuitive. Oh, shit. Boom! Ah, don't like you. Yeah. Down you go. Ooh, a treasure chest? Okay. Alright, I have no idea what that said. Was that an energy get? So I actually got a spare energy tank? Dash ability? You can dash more? Alright. Alright, so now I can use it, I can actually dash far enough. You received a message? Yeah? What the fuck is this?
Attempting to find the Chosen One is as difficult as finding needle in a haystack. My time is limited. Judas has tampered with the Necronomicon.
and has announced that he intends to sacrifice his physical body to cast his self into the virtual world. His goal? Create a child of God. The chosen one is planned, has been selected. Press circle to view details. X to close?
So... Right. Okay. So, if I go through to the pit and up to the right, I'll find the heart and an exit. If I go up to the left, I'll find a trophy. I got a feeling I'm going to go and get the trophy first. Right, so that's... That, so, essentially, somebody sent me a map to get out. Alright. I'm liking this more and more. Ah, the hidden room. Oh, all the monies. Woo! Oh, I'm loving this. Totally empty room. See, I told you there's nothing here. Why did you bother coming? What the? Oh! This is awesome! The world is actually depending on me. I need to bring this down so you guys can see the subtitles a bit better because I'd be a bit worried that you were missing the conversation. Be a little more trusting, a little less pompous. Screw you, guy! He's losing his shit. Cats could listen. Cats could listen to my instructions. This is brilliant. I love this. Actually, like, this is gamer versus developer. Are you angry? How angry are you? You gonna give me a boss to fight? Da, da, da. Oh, this is awesome. Right, the fact that you have what looks to be like a wall that I can't break my way out of makes me want to break through it, you son of a bitch. I love fucking with this guy. This is brilliant. How angry are you? You gonna start singing again? If he starts singing. Yeah, so he said she... Oh! Damn you.
Ah!
Alright, fine then. I'll go and fight Judas. Wait, did he actually say, like, use this time to test this path? Ah, well. Can't do anything about it. And essentially, I've tried to iterate it as many times, go back in, and I'm pretty sure that's going to lead me back to the door, and Judas is the person who's actually standing in control in this whole fucking thing. And I'm not pleased about the idea that he's actually got control over me. Yeah, there's your arrow. Boom! That's you got. Boom. Would cleanse this place? I don't know. Okay, so the Brutal Blade and all these kind of other ones are all sitting here. But I'm tempted to actually do something that... Ooh. Yeah, I've got the uppercut. Bubble? What's bubble? Increases the amount of damage when Icy's energy shield can... Oh, nice! So higher health. And what's perception? Oh, right. So whenever they're attacking, that's actually a bonus. So if I do this... I get regen from actually those things, but I'm trying to figure out whether or not it's worthwhile spending the money on it. Why not? I'll take that, because I'm pretty sure it's going to be more useful. Oh, okay. That's what it was. I thought it was a heart. Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Ah, no, I dove straight into that one again. Boom, boom, boom! Stay down! Oh! Didn't make it out of that one. Ah, no! I was trying to get out of the way. Come on. Get it! Ah, come on! I'm getting my ass beat now. Boom! Cut through you. Alright. That was, not as finessed as I thought it might be, but that wasn't too bad. Okay, unnamed town. No soul in sight. Seems like all the people are gone. It's just robots that are left. I thought it was like in a preserve. Yeah, I'm continuing on my own path. Bye-bye. That felt very gratifying. Down you go. Alright, so I can't... Oh, that was because there was people there. Yeah. This is actually kind of, I do like the fact that the dash is infinite and I can keep myself flying through the trees. It's got a very, Wuxia kind of like thing going on with it. The, what do you call them? Those kind of like period jammers with the magic. Alright, so I have to go this way to explore. I'm going to have to follow his arrows from now onwards. Fine. Okay. I'm going to follow the arrows and do what this guy says. I'm sure there's actually some kind of reasoning to the gameplay on that. Oh, found somebody's house. Boom! Down you go. Is there a way for me to go in there? Nope. Oh, some kind of basement bunker? Right. What the hell is it? Oh, Thor, so there's another one to take down. Okie dokie. So, this guy's on his own. I don't seem to be able to recharge anything from... Oh! That's what I need to... Alright, so I need to avoid. Whoa! Ah! Yeah! Off goes with Thor's head. So I've taken down apathy and loyalty. Interesting. Alright, so now I need to go to those doors. It seems to be like the game's doing that intentional glitch out thing again as well whenever I actually work my way through. Which is, perturbing, because I'm sure there's actually some base story that I'm not getting on. Well, in there, why I was actually not being able to get through. Okay, Brutal Blade. Okay, let's see. I might actually pay for one of these, because I wouldn't mind having more combos to go with, because if I don't have the combos, then I can't really... Oh, that one slashes them down. So is that one a bam bam down? So I don't really want to force myself back to the ground constantly. I like that move. Cyclone. Oh, there we go. 1, 2, 3, triangle. See, I don't want to use up... I don't want any moves that are actually using up my health. That just feels stupid. And that's too much money. So anything I can afford is actually these ones here at the level 0, or... Skull Shaker. I think I might take Skewer. There's another ground combo that I can use. There we go. That works for me. Just doing a little bit of thought process in there, trying to figure out what would be the most common thing for me to do, when, especially if I'm button bashing. It's telling me not to go... I'm going to take a look. I can't help not taking a look. Whoa. There's nothing here. Okay, whatever that was, this just seemed to be a distraction. Okay. Empty city. Down you go. Oh, I don't have to kill everything either. Huh. Put it there if I want to grab the money. Flash level? Oh, I can flash through steel bars? Right. Ah, so that's what its purpose is now, so I can actually like run through hidden parts. Alright, here comes another boss. What's this one called? Puck. Puck you, Puck. Boom! And there's Parker's Lost Heart? Okay. What is that? Parker's Lost Heart's on the... Okay. Right. So the game... It seems to be like the developer creating the game as we work our way through it. And it just teleported me for no reason? But how do I... This is like kind of like almost like that unnecessary or untrustworthy narrator. Seems to be the name of the game for this. Motherfucker. See, it looks like these creatures don't actually have any kind of cores, so they can't re-heal me, which makes the... Whoa. Okay, interesting. This is another lab bit. More monies! And I thought I might have been able to bounce the money around more and get some more out of it. If it, the navigation in this feels so fluid because of the actual, like, whoa. Oh, cool! If it, the navigation feels so simple and easy to work your way through because of the speed with which you can just iterate and try to go somewhere. Again, force me to follow the arrow. Boom, down you go. Nothing there to kill. Alright. I feel like I just kind of like zone out whenever I get into the combat because of how... Oh, whoa. Is that actually someone up there? Oh, there it is. I'm starting to get used to actually spotting these things now as well. So it feels like the combat is kind of like... it feels... mesmerizing whenever you actually really get into the actual the actual battles, you know. What the fuck is this? What the fuck? This doesn't feel like where I was meant to be. Was that a teleport node or something? Alright, is that where I was meant to go? Oh, okay. Doesn't feel like that was where I was meant to go. Huh. That's pretty cool. I like the multiple pathways for working through an area. Because I actually found one that was more secret than the secret, I suppose. Boom, down you go. Anything else want to fucking have a go? Some depths of that cave. Ooh, that looks interesting. Alright, let's see what we got here. Increased damage and chance for energy crystals to appear. Ooh, that might be useful. Although, I think I might need to start worrying about vitality. Yeah, I might go with that first, and then think about deception, and then the rest I'll worry about later. It's like 85, so is there anything I can still do? Is actually like these lower attacks? I'm never going to use Deadly Disc or Shadow Dance. Okay, so that's all the ground combos actually received now, so I shouldn't really have a problem. Alright, let's go. What's the next box got for me? What the hell are you, Carlos? Hello, Carlos! Oh, shit! Oh, Carlos eats you. Ah! Come here. Oh, that's slow. Ah. Ah, come on. Boom! Go through you. And I got Carlos's ambitions. So, I've taken a lot of things from a lot of people's personalities. I'm assuming these individuals are actually... I want you for Judah. I want you for Judas. I want to get out of here. Why did it force a train journey? Is this actually like trying to do a loading screen kind of hide of some sort? That's a bit weird. Okay. Oh man, I originally wanted to just play this for a little bit for a Made in Japan, but it looks like this is going to be a full let's play because I'm actually intrigued. I enjoy the combat in this, and it feels like I'm actually like the hideout clock tower isn't too far away, so I could make it in this one single gameplay. Yeah, of course. I'm going to just take the path. You told me where to go. I'm going to start following your arrows. Let's get this accelerated through. And I'm sure this is going to have multiple playthroughs for different endings. Is there a rave going on out there? Sweet. I love the music in this game as well. This game's got good music. It's got good layout. Whoa. Whoa! So now at the point where I'm going to be fighting bosses as random enemies, that works for me. I'm liking that. I like that escalation. It's one of those things I liked in some games. I mean, back in the day, whenever Final Fight used to do it to you, you'd run into, you'd run into like Hugos much later on in the game, like as just normal bad guys rather than actually as bosses, which just seemed to be a nice touch. They're going like, no, you've gotten so used to this, you can just take down these guys easy, can't you? Okay, I need to find where the entrance of this is. Whoa. Yeah. See, I recognize that logo. That's his logo, so that means like that wall that I couldn't get into earlier on would have probably been that fucker anyway that I'm actually trying to kill. I'm on to you. Wait, what? Wait, what? No! Ah, fuck's sake. feels like I'm actually fighting inside a matrix system that's actually trying to get me to stay. Down you go, fuckhead. Bro, what the fuck? Boom, same place I remember from before. It's weird that that actually exists because... Wait, does that actually produce more money if I go back and do it again? No, it doesn't. I was curious. Thought that might be in a mining spot. Right, let's see. Whoa, that obviously respawned. Whoa! So do I have to actually, like, go back the way... If I know my way out, I can navigate it again? Is that what I meant to do? It's like, is this like a memory test now? Right, let's see. Something I can do. Bubble. So, upgrade. See how much damage I can take before... I can mitigate. Whoa! Who are you? Oh shit. Shit. Boom, there goes one arm. There goes another arm. Boom, there goes your head, fucker. Goodbye. Took out your fucking idyllic resignation. I don't know what the hell that meant, but it felt good. Alright, still don't have the money to really upgrade anything. Okay. Off of your head. Boom, down you go. Okay. Whoa! Whoa!
Oh no, it immediately blew up and caught me.
This feels like I'm going back through places all over again. I don't want to fight these guys. Feels like I'm being lied to constantly now because this does not feel like it's actually progress. Oh fuck.
Oh, God. I'm getting to the point now where I just want this to actually end with this repetition of locations. I mean, the charm was there at the beginning, but it seems like the charm was abandoned. One step closer to the enemy. Oh, God, you serious? Oh, right, we continue on. What the hell's happened?
Oh! Motherfucking game! The game has locked itself up.
Hmm.
So I'm obviously going to have to quit and come back into this game again to play a little bit further. All right, well, this is going to be a two-parter, guys. For first time ever, I'm going to hammer through a game. There will be another video for this up very, very shortly. This has been iCEY, from the Hong Kong PlayStation Store. You can play iCEY on Steam, or you can get it on the Hong Kong PlayStation Store. It currently is on sale on the PlayStation Plus sale on the Hong Kong Store for a few more days. I think it's until the 20th, maybe, or the 10th. But you'd be really, really pushing it to make sure that you get it on time now. Guys, thank you very much for watching. This has been Pasticheofskin playing iCEY for Made in Japan here on the channel. If you actually enjoyed what you were watching, the entire length of the view, you're still here now, and you want to see how this ends, grab the subscribe button up there, and it will tell you when the next video comes up live on YouTube and on many of the other sources. And over here on the side, you can see other episodes of Made in Japan and a bunch of other shows that I've made otherwise. Guys, I'm immediately going to jump out of this, reset the game, start back in again, and do another part of this. So I hope you guys come and join me to see how iCEY ends, because I'm curious about this with this whole kind of Pony Island style kind of narration. So guys, I will see all you dudes in the next episode. Bye.